Playtime Co.'s new patented elastic plastic, you can stretch, pull, and twist Mommy Longlegs in the craziest ways. She loves watching you play. When you're having fun, she's having fun. The new Mommy Longlegs from Playtime Co. What's the time?
Does someone need a hug? Give me a big squeeze. I promise I won't bite. Come closer, friend. I'll squeeze you until you...
Playtime Co. is the product of a great man by the name of Elliot Ludwig, divorced but a family man at heart. His sights were always set on bringing amazing toys to amazing children around the globe. Ludwig spent countless hours in the factory, working overtime relentlessly in an attempt to continuously innovate and surprise. In the 1960s, an unfortunate family death had pushed Ludwig down to his lowest. But with so much ambition, he rose back up and continued to fulfill his vision for the Playtime Co. toy factory. Ludwig could never be content leaving a project unfinished. But just how did one man come to create such an astounding empire? How did he manage to stay determined even after suffering such a tragic loss? It all began in the fateful year of 19...
Listen, I'm going to need you to trust me.
Strong and smart you are. Follow Mommy Longlegs down the stairs, and we'll start by playing musical memory. See you in a bit.
Ha! The wind!
Welcome to Musical Memory. This advanced memory and cognitive recognition test is designed to stimulate several segments of the brain, allowing us to see how quickly and efficiently your brain works. A sequence of colors will be shown, and you must recreate the exact sequence using the buttons around you. Bunzo will slowly lower towards you. When you complete a color pattern correctly, Bunzo will rise back up. When you input a pattern incorrectly, Bunzo will lower towards you faster. If Bunzo reaches you, your test is over. The test will become more difficult as it continues, with longer patterns in quicker succession. That's all. Good luck.
Round 5. G, yellow. by J. Yellow question mark who by well smile smile face revenue smile red menda J red Morgan yellow blue vertical back massive by question mark still revenue Morgan B J question mark who green mark by menda come on menda Morgan question mark smart white smile face vertical back white blue yellow massive red Morgan B smile smile face white black menda red seven red Morgan Morgan smile face.
Code for the train. Look up. Take it. Mommy was hoping the game could last.
Wanna hear a dino joke? Click once for the question, click again for the punchline! What do you call a dino with one eye?
Thank you. finally happened. After years of being ignored, the company actually heard all my complaints. Yep, they listened to them very carefully. I guess my words must have really inspired them to take action. Because the next day I got demoted down here. To the freaking island of misfit toys! Why do I talk to myself?
gave you permission to be this smart. Mommy is super proud of you, but I'm sure she's already told you that herself. Our next game is Wag-O-Wuggy. Head downstairs and have fun.
Welcome to Wag-O-Wuggy. This advanced test is designed to assess the extent of your reactionary abilities. A dual palm grab pack will be provided to you for this test. Around you are 18 sizable holes. An adorable Huggy Wuggy toy could appear out of any one of these holes. If one comes out, hit it with your grab pack. That's all. Good luck.
The toys in this game used to have strings attached to them so they could be pulled back when they got too close to the children. Have fun. The toys in this game used to have strings attached to them so they could be pulled back when they got too close to the children. Have fun. Thank you. Oh, you did it. Hooray! Mommy is so proud of you. Here, Mommy has another hint for you.
The button to feed me candy.
I was heading home for the day, when my afars realized that I left my bloody wallet in the cafeteria. So I'm running through the lobby, and that's when I see it. A mop handle lodged under the innovation wing gate.
So what'd you do, Marcus?
Well, I just thought I'd nab the bloody yoke of on me merry way.
And?
Well, I'm reaching for the thing, and the mop handle jolts on its own. Had me scared stiff. I thought I was the only one there. So I took a peek beneath the gate, and some massive bloody thing was doddering about the bloody hallway.
Thing? You're sure it wasn't a person?
Ain't no person that's 50 feet long with 1,000 legs.
Marcus, you're losing me. Maybe you just saw a bunch of people walking by.
Look, it wasn't people, all right? I haven't a bloody notion what it was, but it wasn't human.
Who have you told about this? Besides me, obviously.
Just you, sir. Obviously.
Okay. I'll have security skim the cameras and take a look.
What? There's a massive bloody monster! Skimming ain't gonna get rid of it!
You're out of line, Marcus. We make toys, not monsters. Now come on, get out of my sight. Actually, grab me a coffee, will you? Actually, never mind. Get out of my sight.
Before. You're so good! Seems like you're ready for the final game, statues! Follow Mommy down the stairs one last time. I hope you had a fun day at the game station. See you next time!
Do you want to play with PJ?
Welcome to Statues. This advanced obstacle course is designed to test your physical endurance and strength. The rules are simple. The lights will turn off. You can move through the obstacle course at this time. However, when the lights turn on, you can look around but cannot move. You may move again once the lights turn back off. The lovable PJ Pugapillar will follow you. If PJ reaches you, your test is over. That's all. Good luck.
It was always so sad to see the kids go. They called me Mommy because I was the closest thing they ever had to one. But they come for games and never come back. They left Mommy to die alone. Mommy didn't deserve that. But you worked here. So if anyone deserves to die alone,
bye. The world.
Jimmy, your work as Playtime Co.'s chief marketing officer has skyrocketed the company's profits. How do you do it?
You know, it's not what you'd expect. It's the little things most people don't even think about. Like, take names, for example. Express people haven't realized this. You take the E sound, slap it on the end of a name, boom, you're making bank. Huggy, Mommy. Even Elliot knew this way back with Poppy.
I guess I kind
of... Blue. Blue is huge, I'm telling you. What's your favorite color? Blue? I bet it's blue, right? It's blue?
It's green.
Okay, well, you're a special case. Most people would say blue. But seriously, marketing is not as easy as you think. I make it look easy. If there's anything Playtime Co. should be known for, it's not toys. It's marketing.
Boogie.
following is a pre-recorded announcement to address the many complaints regarding an alleged very, very big spider crawling around in the facility. The Playtime Corporation wants me to remind you all that spiders that big do not exist, and that if they did, quote, we would already be dead anyways, end quote. Regardless, you can all rest assured the company is sending some specialists down here to have a look around and relieve the constant whining. Complaining seems to be everyone's primary contribution to this company. It's just a spider. You are all safe. Please, please, carry on with your jobs.
Thank you. Ha ha ha! Log code 08502. In relation, experiment 1006. The prototype. A close call occurred this week in which he nearly breached containment. The prototype seemingly disassembled the digital alarm clock within his room and utilized the battery, along with several other components, to create a laser pointer, which he then fired into the security camera, disabling it. These actions allowed him 28.3 seconds completely unmonitored. Once function returned to the camera, the room appeared to be empty. One surveillance specialist went in to confirm his absence. However, upon opening the door, she realized that the prototype had hidden in one of the camera's blind spots. The prototype attempted to escape through the open door. However, another surveillance specialist was able to remotely relock the door, despite the other specialist still being inside. One casualty occurred. The prototype seems to possess an unprecedented level of intelligence beyond that of all other test subjects, as well as an alarming willingness to commit violence. Further suppression treatments will need to be enacted to ensure that no other experiments develop these qualities. Experiment 1170, Huggy Wuggy, remains the optimal outcome due to his sufficient intelligence paired with maximum obedience. End of log.
Did you kill her? Good. I'll board the train. We need to leave.
Thank you.
she put me back in that case. But you saved me. You are perfect. Too perfect to lose. I'm sorry. I can't let you leave. I've never met anyone like you. Do you know how long I've been stuck in that case? Well, too long. I had so much time to think and reflect. Time to figure out exactly what I would do when free. We'll set things right. Terrible things have happened. But I know that whatever I need you to do, you're capable. We will. What if...